This engine's looking fairly clean without too much wear after it was pressure washed. So I think we'll try to find a way to make an engine stand for it so we can get it running. First thing to do is to find something suitable out of the scrap metal that we can use to make this work. I think a couple of these is going to give me some idea on how to mount it. This used to be some sort of monitor stand, and I'm trying to figure out how to get it horizontal for a vertical shaft engine. And I'm thinking that I'm going to use this rebar to attach and just weld on each side here. And that should work. And then I'll put a hole in the center here. I'm going to drill a hole in the center so that the crankshaft can go through. Put some hearing protection on. Okay, last nut. just do it. Okay, it's going to be mounted soon. Okay, we're here at Wilco. Gonna get some bolts and nuts to finish the job. Okay, we'll get some grade 8, 5/16. And these are the ones. So that should be good. Here's how we're looking with the bolts. And they'll be going in place just as soon as you finish drilling these out. Then we'll put it back together, and this is a working engine stand for lawnmower engines. It's all cleaned now and ready for the engine to go on. Can tilt it up and could even put the damper on the belt pulley. Put that on too. I may bend these rebar to fit over into the other mounts there. Instead of this original one for the electric starter, I'm going to put something on that it could allow us to do it by hand with a pull start. We're gonna bend these to make them. Cherry red so we can bend it easily. Okie dokie. Okay, we're going to arc weld that together. And then it should be okay. Too much, huh? So success, and it comes apart completely, disassembles with those two bolts there and the bolt there. It all disassembles properly. So it's good and solid too. Rock solid. Okay, that's a good stand for working on engines. Small ones. Should be 1/8 the trouble, right?